control. Especially we saw villages which were like under program of Nobel laureate Modi. Being a Muslim country also, a very good population control program, and every single family had only two children. That's not, in India also, that's not dealt with. Regarding social and economic issues, though they were poor, their incomes were low, they were very matured at that level, especially women were very matured. So you can compare all this with Bangladesh. Even United Nations has written, they used to call Bangladesh sorrow of the world. Nickname of, what you call, name of Bangladesh was sorrow of the world, because they had always flood and famines, and later on they had always hurricanes and lot of things disturbing. Still, they have good standards, social standards. So these are all facts I have brought before you. I think I have dealt with lot of topics. Actually, you can read here. They have given gender empowerment measures, means especially regarding, if you think of what you call SHG, self-help group, which was almost, I think Bangladesh was a pioneer, and Muhammad Yunus was developed that self-help group sort. His bank was about, his bank had deposits of 15,000 crore rupees, 50,000 crore rupees. 98% members were only women, means depositors were only women. Karja ya loan jo diya jata hai, loan facility women ko hi di jati hai. And they had small groups like apne yahan society ya jaise rehte, aur unko diya jata hai. Aur slabs bhi hai ki 2 lakh ke upar kisko bhi, वो डाका बोलते हैं, 2 लाख डाका के ऊपर किसको भी पैसा नहीं दिया जाए. स्टिल इफ यू लुक एट देयर फिगर्स इन वुमेन एम्प्लॉयमेंट, दे आर वेरी हाई, एंड इफ यू लुक एट फिगर्स ऑफ इंडिया, इट्स वेरी लो. तो इससे वो पता चलता है. आई थिंक आई हैव गिवन लॉट ऑफ नाउ इनपुट्स टू यू. आई थिंक वी ऑलमोस्ट डेल्ट विद ऑल आई थिंक कॉर्नर्स ऑफ इकोनॉमी. नाउ any questions or any, what do you say, any queries?
Like, as India has gone for nuclear deal, but since India is spending a lot of money on that, I think around 1200 megawatt of energy, India is spending around $120 billion around. So instead of going for that, if India would have invested that money in creating small dams, with which not only India will be able to solve the irrigation problem also, plus the energy that would be producing from there would be much more than that. And the problem with nuclear deal is also that the whatever would be the waste of nuclear, what would be the nuclear waste would be there, there is a great problem of dumping that. Plus, there might be some, if they go for any kind of nuclear test, that supply would also be get cancelled, or that deal will get cancelled. So instead of going for that, if India would have invested their money on creating small dam, I think that would be much better than
I got your point. Actually, there are two different issues. One is electricity. I told you regarding growth rates, electricity growth and all. Now, if you do thermal plants and hydro plants, there is hardly any hydro plant which is more than 40 megawatt. Now our deficit is about 15,000 megawatt, which in 2012 is to be going to be 1 lakh megawatt. See the deficit. Now one nuclear plant can install 2,000 megawatt of energy. So that's the difference I told you. And there are many more problems, like you can't order a turbine just now. Abhi laga humko kal turbine baithna hydro project mein, nahi kar sakte. टाइम फेज, इफ यू आर गोइंग टू गो इन इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, उसका एक डैम कितना देगा, 40 मेगावाट देगा, फिर डैम कितना करना पड़ेगा, इट्स अ ह्यूज इश्यू. लाइक यू कांट डेल्ट इट विथ वन नाइट. अगर करना है तो वी हैव टू टारगेट 2024. तो ये इश्यू के लिए दिस इज वी हैव गॉन फॉर दिस ऑप्शन आई थिंक सो. एंड नंबर टू इज व्हेन वी थिंक ऑफ एनवायरमेंट, एक्चुअली मैं उस पर भी लेक्चर आई वॉज थिंकिंग ऑफ जस्ट गिविंग अ लेक्चर ऑन एनवायरमेंट इशू, लेकिन आज क्योंकि उस पर भी मैंने काफी ये किया है. तो इफ यू थिंक इन एनवायरमेंट पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू दो चीज है. इफ यू गो फॉर लाइक क्रूड ऑयल एनर्जी, इफ यू गो फॉर से एग्जाम्पल थर्मल एनर्जी, नाउ दे से इन ग्लोबल वार्मिंग, हैव सीन द फिल्म इनकन्वीनियंट ट्रूथ बाय अल गोर, या हैव सीन इट? सो 67% ऑफ ग्लोबल वार्मिंग इज नॉट ड्यू टू पेट्रोल डीजल और अदर इंडस्ट्रियल, जस्ट ड्यू टू कोल एंड बर्निंग ऑफ कोल. सो वन थिंग इज ग्लोबल वार्मिंग एंड सेकेंड थिंग, सेकेंड फियर इज न्यूक्लियर वेस्ट. आई नो देर इज अ फियर इन न्यूक्लियर वेस्ट बिकॉज इन फ्रांस ऑल्सो दे हैड एक्सीडेंट, there was in Chernobyl there was accident, so it can happen such, but we have no other options. Kal agar electricity band ho jaye, see if we go for a deficit from 15,000 megawatt, now Maharashtra is facing a deficit of 4,000 megawatt, country is facing a deficit of 15,000 megawatt, and if this deficit goes to 1 lakh megawatt total, totally our growth rate will be hampered, our industrial growth will be hampered, everything will be hampered. I don't think we'd have good life standards also. So ye pura economy pe hi hai. And the, I will tell you, the real issues are now energy. It's regarding crude oil, it's regarding fertilizer, is also energy for food and electricity. So we have to deal these three energies very professional way, which we did earlier 3-4 decades ago. We should have worked out that time only. Now we are started working out for it.
One more question, if you permit.
Yeah, of course.
But like as you said that our export percentage and import percentage is an almost negligible. Like export percentage around 0.8%. So but in, if you take it another way, because of this only, today India is, India's economic position is quite strong if we compare with other countries, and the job cuts problem is also very less in India today, right now, because whatever we produce, that is consumed by our own domestic market. And most of the industries are, whatever they are producing, because of strong demand from the domestic market, they are, all the products are consumed by India only. So we don't have much to export, and We don't even importing also much. So in this, if we take it another way, so in this way, this is making our economy more stronger than other countries.
No, good question. This is a very good question. This is a question which can be answered for like, one thing is there, like we were almost buffer state before 1990, like. We were not involved in globalization, global economy. After our policies changed, we opened up, we came into global economy around, say, 2099 or 2000. Now, we have foresight of planning regarding exports, export-oriented good, that sort of industries. Now, there are two things. Like, first is, now you said it's good. It's good that now, today's crisis, we are not there. We are directly involved in it. We are almost buffered by all these things because domestically we are bigger consumers. Domestic consumption is higher. Okay. Now, next thing is, are we going to be in globalization just due to fear of ki ye ho gaya, layman mein idhar ho gaya, udhar ho gaya? उसमें हम रोल प्ले कर रहे हैं कि नहीं, हमको करना पड़ेगा. बिकॉज नाउ नेक्स्ट इकोनॉमी, सी इफ यू स्टडी ऑल द इकोनॉमिक्स, लाइक इफ यू स्टडी कैन्स, इफ यू स्टडी लाइक मार्क्स, इफ यू स्टडी मेंडीज, और इवन अमर्त्य सेन और जेफरी सच, इफ यू स्टडी ऑल दीज इकोनॉमीज, दे हैव डेल्ट विद जस्ट नेशनल इकोनॉमी. and less on global trade and all sort of. Now a phase is evolving, which is a global economy phase. Now we have to study formulas on global economy. We have to study logic in it, which now I think we have started doing it. America has initiated. Now George Bush has done a summit, I think. 10 days earlier there was a summit, and now we are going in such a phase that we should go for now global economic evolution or that sort of phase. Now we can't be just an isolated country which will be independent in itself and all. We can't be like that. We have to go for that.
Sir, Nobel laureate Muhammad Yunus, he is famous for his Grameen model.
Grameen model, which is
closely related to microfinance.
Sir, my question is, do you think Microfinance Institute has power to alleviate the poverty from this total world, from this global scenario?
Good question again. Actually, I should tell you, when I was visiting Bangladesh, I was rather skeptical ki jab main ja raha tha, तब सब बोले कहाँ ढाका जाना है तो जेनेवा जाओ, ज्यूरिख जाओ, यहाँ क्या जाते हो, क्या है वहाँ. तो फर्स्ट डे वी हैड अ विजिट टू द बैंक, एंड बैंक वाज लाइक इट वाज अ 24 स्टोरी बैंक विद 50,000 करोड़ ऑफ डिपॉजिट. एंड आई थॉट, आई वाज स्केप्टिकल, ये सब मेकअप हुआ होगा, ये हुआ होगा. बट व्हेन वी सेकंड डे व्हेन वी विजिटेड the sites and we saw self-help groups, we spoke with women over there, their leaders and all. That time really it was like mind-blowing. Phir pata chala isko Nobel kyun mila, tab pata chala. So when deep basic, if we go for SHG, I think it would be a good program. But another thing is, now actually India has gone in SHG from I think 2001 mein se SHG है. बैंक्स उनको कर्जा दे रहे, मेरे क्षेत्र में भी सेल्फ हेल्प ग्रुप्स है, लेकिन मैं वहाँ देखा कि वहाँ वो प्रोफेशनल टच नहीं है. कुछ तो भी 10 वुमन्स आ गई और हमको कर्जा दो, तो वो जो कंसेप्ट है उसका, बचत का या सेविंग का, वो एक्चुअली वो पूरा इमोशनली उसको डीप डाउन जाना चाहिए. सो इट्स नॉट पेनिट्रेट हैज इट वॉज इन बांग्लादेश. तो आई थिंक इफ आई थिंक देर आर डिबेट्स इन सम मैगजीन्स ऑल्सो आई रेड लास्ट टू लास्ट वीक दैट ओनली सच सॉर्ट ऑफ स्मॉल ग्रुप्स और स्मॉल लेंडिंग्स और वॉट यू कॉल दे कॉल इट माइक्रो फाइनेंस. सो दिस माइक्रो फाइनेंस विल हेल्प बैंक्स एंड ऑल. I feel microfinance can help. Even I feel that might be now in global economy, it may evolve that small industry, what we earlier used to call small scale industry, which was a word Gandhiji used or Pandit Jawaharlal Nehruji used. Now, due to corporate world, these all small cottage industries, it was a word called cottage industries, went up, vanished up. All small scale were also flushed. Now I think instead of corporate big companies, global economies may be so evolved that less corporate, less global, and small industries can cater well than these big industry. But it may happen like 2 decades after, 3 decades after. I feel so. So small is beautiful. It was who quoted it? It was a book written by a big philosopher, Schopenhauer. Small is beautiful. It was a book written by a philosopher 50 years back, and he quoted all these things, that small the things, small the, jaisa Gandhiji kehte the ki a village should be self-sufficient. Pata nahi, ye economy shayad evolve bhi ho jaye.
Thank you, sir. We understood what you want to say really. In the time of knowledge-based globalized economy, gyan adharit vaishvik arthvyavastha ke samay mein, aap kehna chahte hain, India can become a developed country while there is proper coordination in between global India and rural India. Environment of global India is based on knowledge, information technology, and energy production. An environment of rural India is based on knowledge agriculture, or we can say sustainable agriculture. In India, there is no lacking of resources. Lacking is in proper coordination, distribution of resources, and effective implementation of policies. If we want to develop India, we have to develop our primary education system of country. We need quality education. We need to bridge this gap in Indian scenario. And for that, I would like to assure you that we are here in the form of different expressions of MIT School of Government. You can believe me, sir, we all are the divine picture of developed India. As you said, MIT School of Government is a temple of learning. We are very happy to see ourselves as a pillars of the MIT School of Government temple. On behalf of entire MIT Parivar, we are very thankful to you for your informative, research, and experience-based teaching-learning process. Now, I request everyone.
See, export growth and share in world exports of selected country.
जो अर्लियर हमने बात किया था, अब देखो वी कैन सी लाइक जस्ट सी शेयर इन वर्ल्ड एक्सपोर्ट्स 2007, चाइना इज 8.4 विच इज वन ऑफ द हाईएस्ट. तो चाइना इज अ मेजर एक्सपोर्टर इन द वर्ल्ड. अब हम बोलते हैं कि व्हाई चाइना इज इंप्रूविंग, इतना क्यों हो रहा है. इट्स मेजर एक्सपोर्टर. जो कुछ वो प्रोड्यूस करते हैं वो खुद की कंट्री नहीं कंज्यूम करती. वॉट एवर इट प्रोड्यूसर्स उसका माल ज्यादातर बाहर जाता है, इसलिए इट्स इन अ सेफर पोजिशन. इट्स इकोनॉमी इज इन सेफर पोजिशन. स्टिल अभी वर्ल्ड क्राइसिस के बाद, ये जो क्राइसिस हुआ है उसके बाद, वो सबसे डिफिकल्ट पोजिशन में जो जाने वाला है वो चाइना है. नंबर टू इज हांगकांग 2.4. Also, why share is high? You must be knowing Hong Kong.